नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम लाइव ऑन फेसबुक एज वेल एज इंस्टाग्राम ऑन माई ऑफिशियल पेजेस। जस्ट वेट फॉर अ कपल ऑफ मिनट्स फॉर अ फ्यू मोर पीपल टू ज्वाइन एंड देन वील बिगिन द प्रोसीडिंग्स। First of all, apologies for not being present on the last Sunday. So today I'm going to compensate with playing all the four ragas, the ragas that I presented in the last week and the week previous to it. So the four ragas are Rageshri, Pilu, Nand and Marubihag. I'll just play the alaps of each of these ragas. All these ragas are beautiful ragas, and lot of emotional ragas these are. So I will begin with Nand. Kannadadalli kuda maatadi anta kelavaru kelkondidare, ellarigu namaskara. ರಾಗಟೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸಂಡೇ ಲೈವ್ಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಸ್ವಾಗತ, ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ನಾನು ನುಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ರಾಗ ರಾಗ ನಂದ್. ಕುಚ್ ಲೋಗೋನೆ ಕಹಾ ಆಪ್ ಹಿಂದಿ ಮೇ ಭಿ ಥೋಡಾ ಬಾತ್ ಕರಿಯೇಗಾ, ತೋ ಹಿಂದಿ ಮೇ ಭಿ ಮೈ ಬತಾ ರಹಾ ಹೂಂ ಕಿ ಆಜ್ ಚಾರ್ ರಾಗ ಹಮ್ ಲೋಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಕರ್ ರಹೇ ಹೈ, ಮತಲಬ್ ಮೈ ಬಜಾನೆ ಜಾ ರಹಾ ಹೂಂ ಆಲಾಪ್ ಚಾರ್ ರಾಗೋ ಕೆ. ಔರ್ ವೋ ಚಾರ್ ರಾಗ ಹೈ ರಾಗೇಶ್ವರಿ, ಪೀಲು, ನಂದ್ ಔರ್ ಮಾರು ಬಿಹಾಗ್. ತೋ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ವಿತ್ this very touching and beautiful raga called Nand. Someone pointed out, Tu Jaha Jaha, that song is based, only the first part is based on Nand. This is Nand. Now let's move on to another beautiful rag, rag Pilu. I was inspired by Pandit Bhimsen Joshi's Nadiya Kinare. That's how I first understood the niceties and the beauty elements of Pilu. So it's quite challenging on the flute to bring out the emotions, because the Gandhar of Pilu, to get it right, is it requires a lot of penance and sadhana. I'm still trying. I don't think I have got it completely yet, but it's a journey. Classical music is always a journey. Moving on to our next raga, it's Rageshri. This is again one of my favorite ragas. Ragas like Rageshri, Bageshri are very beautiful ragas, Shringar Pradhan ragas, and there's a lot of possibility in performing them in Gayaki or the Tantrakari style. I have recorded a few bandish of Rageshri in various tals, and so I really enjoy playing Rageshri. I hope so. I'm sorry, I'm getting a lot of messages, but I won't be able to respond because too many messages, and then I forget what I have to speak. So kindly excuse me. Maybe in the end of this episode, I may take a few questions. I just saw someone on Facebook asking about the difference between Rageshri and Bhagyashri. Bhagyashri I have already covered. So the basic difference is the Komal Gandhar in Bhagyashri and Shuddha Gandhar in Rageshri. In addition to that, there is a Vakra usage of Pancham in Bhagyashri. In Rageshri, we don't have that Sanghati. So that is the difference between Bhagyashri and Rageshri. The last raga for today is Marugiha. Requesting for Jagu, main sari rehna, that's what I'm playing. Thank you. Yes, sir. Now, I'll see if I can answer a few questions. A lot of questions on Instagram. Sorry. Someone is saying, sir, please play Miyake Malhar. Okay? And thank you, everybody. Especially Bobby Brown. Thank you so much. Nice to see you here again. Bala Mahesh, Mysore. And many of my regular visitors on the Facebook page, and I love you all. Thank you so much for all the love that you've given. Some usual questions. Sir, aap online flute sikhate hain? Haan, bilkul sikhata hoon, lekin आप संजोग बांसुरी महाविद्यालय के फेसबुक पेज पे जाएं और वहाँ पे अपने डिटेल्स डीएम कर लें. हम लोग हमें से कोई आपसे ज़रूर बात करेगा. Someone is asking about the pitch of my flute. It's E, सफ़ेद तीन बिली मूरू. E natural is what I use for classical music, which has become kind of a standard for all classical, Hindustani classical flautists. But I also, in Jugalbandis we play D, and in recordings we use different pitches. For fusion I generally prefer to play in D, so that I can play in both the ranges, the middle octave and the lower octave. Thank you Arjun Sharma, thank you so much. Yeah, Sukhinder, love you too. Thank you so much. Fayazul Haq is asking, sir, what is your favorite raga? It's difficult to identify one, because I love all the ragas. Some of my favorites are Yaman, Shuddha Kalyan, Rageshri, Abhogi, Pahadi, Darbari Kannada. Maukit Gupta on Instagram says, words fall short for your talent. Thank you. I'm blessed to be a musician, and thank you for all the love. And on Facebook, Archana Roy says, please play Marwa. Bobby Brown says, Pahadi Dhun, please. You know what? This Sunday Live is basically for the ragas that I've already discussed in the previous week. So, if I play all the ragas during my live sessions, then you wouldn't watch my regular episodes on Ragatainment. So, I've already covered 26 ragas. So, if you want, you can ask me some raga that I've already presented in Ragatainment. But I will in this session, I will play something for you. Some people are asking about the mic that I use. It's an AKG mic that I use. Alaya Bilawal, Kalish Pujar is asking for Alaya Bilawal. Bivash Singha is asking for Puriya Dhanashri. Murthy Rajiv says, hello sir, love from US, introduce my friends here to Indian music from your podcast, and now they are addicted to it. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, God bless you. Who is your flute maker? Please tell about him. From a very, very long time, since my father, when he started playing the flute and manufacturing himself, he got in touch with Hegde's, M.V. Hegde from Sirsi, and his son Guru Prasad Hegde, who incidentally is also my student. So they are the ones who bring me bamboos, and we sit together and prepare our flutes. Some of my flutes are specifically designed for my fingering, so I kind of sit through and get my flutes done. More or less, the final tuning, pitching, and everything I do it myself. So yeah, you can get in touch with Guru Prasad Hegde if you need flutes. If you want the contacts of the flute maker, then even then you can find him on Facebook, but otherwise you can also contact Sanjog Bansuri Mahavidyalaya page on Facebook and or on Instagram, and we will send you the links. Hegde Aniket, sir, he is learning Hindustani classical music, all about listening to greats and emulating them. That's a way to begin, I would say. But you always need a guru to guide you, because Hindustani music or classical music is so vast that it is difficult to copy just by listening to recordings, because there are several techniques and several minor things as far as raga is concerned, as far as laya is concerned, the shruti is concerned. So you need a proper guidance. So if you sit with a guru and learn for several years, then you will get a hang of classical music. So it's essential. But you can definitely be inspired by the lives of these wonderful legends. And as I mentioned earlier in this episode, it's a sadhana. It's not a, I would say it's always a journey. There's no end to classical music. The possibilities, the permutations and combinations that the ragas offer us are infinite. So we just have to keep learning every day. Vikas Sutradhar on Facebook says, sir, main Bangalore mein rehta hoon, aapse flute seekhne ke liye bahut din se sapna dekh raha hoon, sir. As I said, aap please Sanjog Bansuri Mahavidyalaya Facebook page pe apne details chhod dijiye. Hum mein se koi aapse contact karega aur fir ऑनलाइन क्लासेस या जब हम लाइव क्लासेस शुरू करेंगे तो आप जरूर उसमें शामिल हो सकते हैं. बट लीव योर डिटेल्स, डीएम कर दीजिए, संजोग बांसुरी महाविद्यालय, SANJOG, संजोग बांसुरी महाविद्यालय. कविता कश्यप से, सर यू आर माई फेवरेट फ्लूटिशियंस फ्रॉम माई चाइल्डहुड, ब्लेस टू हियर ऑल द रागास ऑफ द इवेंट. थैंक यू कविता, थैंक यू सो मच, गॉड ब्लेस यू टू. Ganesh Hatwar, sir, can we play by mixing Carnatic and Hindustani style based on swara of particular ragas? Of course you can. I mean, there are several ragas which have similar swaras, so you can definitely mix. And the basic idea of both the streams of classical music, Hindustani and Carnatic, is to present the bhav of the raga, raga bhav, the emotional content. So it could be Hindustani or Carnatic, you can definitely mix, but you need to have authority on both the systems to a certain extent to be able to do justice to it. Archana Roy asked for Marwa. Prahlad Kulkarni says, sir, some suggestions please on practicing bansuri, not disturbing neighbors. Play something that they like to listen, or best make them sit along with you and listen to you, so that they are forced to enjoy your music. But otherwise, some fingering without producing the sound you can practice without blowing through the flute, but it won't help in the long run. Only to a very minimal extent you can do that. But flute is such an instrument which is completely dependent on the breath. So every moment you have to check your breath, your lip position, and several other things. So without producing a sound, you can't. And ಹೌದು ಈಗ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಪ್ರತೀಕ್, ನಾನು ಎಂ ಬಿ ಹೆಗಡೆಯವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿರೋ ಫ್ಲೂಟ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನೇ ನಾನು ಬಳಸೋದು. ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಕೊಳಲನ್ನು ತಯಾರಿ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ನಿಖಿಲ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೆ ಸೇಸ್, ಶೇರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಜರ್ನಿ ಎಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಏಜ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ಜಿ? Well, since I was fortunate to have my father, Pandit Venkatesh Gurkhindi ji, so my learning, formal learning, began around the age of 3 with a small tiny straight flute. But my I had music in my genes, in my blood, so I was blessed to be born in this family. And 24/7 my father was there to guide me, so that's how I began. I will talk about my entire journey some other time, because it's a long journey, and you know, several incidents. Kaushik Ghoshal says, Pranam Guruji, keenly looking forward to listen to you at Swar Samrat Festival 2021. Yes, me too. I am also looking forward. I have one question. What is your thought on 4-octave or 5-octave flutes? Are those authentic to use in classical music? Well, it depends how effective and how tuneful it is. But 2 octaves is more than enough to present classical music, I guess. That is my personal experience. So you actually don't need, but if you can, then nothing like it. And that's another added advantage of being able to play in different octaves. I have never tried doing that. I have stuck to the usual Hindustani flute, 2.5 octaves, and I'm happy with it. I keep changing flutes for the Mandra Saptak. I have created something called as Alto Bansuri, wherein with the same fingering I can play the lower E bass. In my next Sunday live, I'm going to demonstrate a few of my flutes, so watch out for that. Any other... Okay, so... I shall conclude today's episode. Let's do one thing. I give you 3 ragas. You have to choose one of them. Let's see. Whichever catches my eye, that's what I'm going to play. So the ragas that, the choice of ragas is Marwa, Pahadi, and Niyaki Malhar. So quickly type and let me know which one you want to hear. Marwa, Pahadi, or Niyaki Malhar. Pahadi, I got 2, 3, 4. A lot of Pahadis on Instagram. Okay, Marwa, Malhar. Girish Kulkarni, Namaskar, Marwa. Okay, then I'll play Marwa. I'm sure now everybody will say play both. Okay. Just for today, I'm deviating from the rule of presenting a new raga, which is not discussed in my Raga Tenement regular episodes. I'll play Pahadi first, and then Marwa.
Thank you.
thank you everybody. I hope you enjoyed the Sunday live of Ragatainment. Do join me next Sunday. And I'm thinking of doing Sundays once in a fortnight from hence, from here onwards. So I need your feedback. As of now, I'll be coming live on next Sunday, but let's see. But don't forget to watch my regular Ragatainment episodes on Mondays and Thursdays at 9 a.m. on my official Facebook and Instagram pages. Thank you once again for joining. And before I conclude, I would like to mention a couple of my students who have performed using the hashtag Ragatainment. Madhu Kulkarni, she performed Rag Rageshri, and another of my disciple Parth, he performed Rag Desh. So I once again put out this request. Any of you want to present any ragas, compositions based on any of the ragas that I've presented already through Ragatainment, just use the hashtag Ragatainment and record the video and tag me. Use the hashtag and let's all enjoy the beauty of Indian classical music. Thank you once again for joining. Today's episode was quite long, and my namaskars to everybody who have stayed throughout the episode. And God bless you all. Stay safe and enjoy music. God bless you all. Namaskar.